Welcome everybody here to the D2CL. I'm Toby One, your host for the English live streamer, and I have the power because I have taken over the hosting. There has been some server problems, hence we took so long to actually start up the game, and we had problems initially with BU, then we had problems with our hosts. Both of the admins who were here were unable to actually make any changes inside the lobby. Everything was lagging too much for them. So do not fear, I have an admin ticket. We're launched! We're in! The draft is underway! And the most powerful hero inside the meta is now in the hands of the team who is one game up. But he will be denied the combination. The combination which... Oh, was it... You know what? As you get older, your memory starts to fade. We had the combination of Troll and Sniper together yesterday. And the combination was in the hands of no one. Not from the game of NIP. They had Troll as well as Templar Assassin was the combination which, sorry, Team Empire ended up using. There was only one Troll game that came out from NIP yesterday in the hands of Era, and they used him in a combination with Enigma, Lina, as well as Vengeful Spirit. Their last pickup in that one was also the Clockwork. And as we can see right now, they're not going to get the Vengeful Spirit, but they do have the Clockwork to go with a combination if their heart doth desire to have those things. So, yeah, Clockwork, Troll Warlord. The thing you always have to do, and to kind of flag the fact too when you see a Storm Spirit ban out by My Nuts, because he just knew instantly, Sniper, I'm wanting to pick him. I've got first pick. I'm going to pick the Sniper if they let me have him. So I'm going to take out the jump-based heroes. Batrider and Storm Spirit, two of the greatest ones. Normally you have Batrider as well as Clockwork. I mean, sorry, the Storm Spirit as well as the Clockwork as the two heroes that the greatest at catching out Sniper, because he can't do anything about them coming in on him. It's just not possible. And then the Clockwork obviously keeps him in close with the cogs, and the Storm Spirit is just able to keep on dodging, avoids the shrapnels, and just keeps bouncing around. The Sniper can't get really a lock on him. So that's the reason why those two heroes were banned out at the very, very start. Looks like My Nuts has also done his homework, taking out that Lina. So he won't give the combination to run. It was a solo mid Lina, which is a little bit of a surprise when they ran the VS and the Lina in the round before. As two supports. So the roaming supports, they ran that way. But the Lina was banned out anyway. Disruptor taken out. So more of that wonderful chase mechanism. I'm also thinking that might be because we're looking at a high maneuverable hero. Someone like that. The man who sprints himself to victory. The Slaughter pickup. Interesting choice to have up against someone like a Troll Warlord. The Amplify is going to be crazy. If you actually start thinking about the combinations you get, with Amplify, Wave of Terror, and you throw out Shrapnel as well, you're going to get pummeled. And of course, Sniper, with Assassination too, I doubt anyone. Like, you never lose vision of him. You know where you're fighting. You're up against two melee, one semi.
5 seconds remaining.
He's all rounder. Like, he's not hard, he's not soft, he's just a semi. This Troll Warlord.
Reserve
both
time.
Range and melee. And with the Slaughter selection, this almost feels like a nice early Roshan as well. But they're over on the Radiant side, so it's not just a simple slip yourself in and take out Roshan. It didn't stop Ninjas in Pyjamas during the last map. They just ran themselves in. The five-man smoke moved inside. If it wasn't for the Vengeful Spirit with the Wave of Terror, they never would have... Well, they would have known. They just wouldn't have been sure what was going on. Okay, so Ninjas in Pyjamas. Fourth pickup to go. They have a lot of melee. They need some range. And they know they need some survivability here. I'm really liking BU's lineup. I'm still... question marking what's going to happen with the Slaughter. If I was Ninjas in Pyjamas right now, I'd make sure that Lion cannot be selected, because I'm really worried what's going to happen to these NIP players. Actually, is it Lion would be the best one? You kind of want a 4-star hero as well. But the VS has got the swap, so technically she can just save anyone who gets caught inside the cogs if they're worth saving. Really?
Radiant team pick.
Okay. Okay. I'm trying to fully understand this, because the Bane really isn't the jump hero I was looking for. You can't... Like Clockwork's kind of that, but... Understanding the synergy for this. Like, what's your setup? Like, if you had something like a Mirana, then I can kind of understand it. Maybe they're looking at something more like a Latrak, where they can add a lot of early pressure, then there's a lot of spill damage coming out to the slot if he comes for them. But the Latrak would just get melted by the Sniper, so that can't really be an option. Then what are they going to do? Put a Troll Warlord up against a Sniper in the mid? You could potentially run a dual lane in mid, but... Okay, you get an Ancient Apparition as well. AA and VS. Ban. Quite a powerful combination. Not because you're always thinking like the stun combinations, like you have like the old Rubik's and AA together, where you, like, you know you're going to get your cold feet off, and at level 3 you got your nice burst damage coming out from Rubik, and they've both got some good physical DPS. But with VS adding in the Wave of Terror with the Chilling Touch, just that very early damage you get from VS and AA, like you can't take any fight you want to. And with the Sniper in the mid, you combine all this stuff together, and you've got great battles. And this will buy time for Slaughter to what should be the most obvious pickup in this game, pick up something like a Vanguard, as well as his Blink Dagger. So he's got enough life points to jump in, he'll have that block, and he'll have the survivability as the primary thing, to be in the face of ninjas in pajamas and just try and destroy them. Because if he's the one doing that, and NIP focus on him, then the Sniper just goes to work Radiant sitting at the back lines. Band. And that's where I'm still not quite sure about this. Like, how are you meant to get the jump when I'm fairly certain the Clockwork is not going to find a line of fire to get that hookshot onto the Sniper? And he's the only one right now. The Puck was the final ban out by NIP. So they have to be worried that it's going to hit massively team fight controlled. Yeah.
5 seconds remaining.
And Bird and United, they could kind of pick anything they want to on this off. You know what I'd actually really like to see? Time. I don't know if that'd be perfect. But Timbersaw's in my mind right now for Burden United. Because I think it's just going to... It's nice enough you don't really care about hitting directly. He can shred apart that Troll Warlord. And the Slaughter will take care of kind of everybody else. That's another one of those big tanky guys you can put up the front line. So you put the Timbersaw on the off lane. Earthshaker and Bane shouldn't be able to harass him out of the lane. And if they do get a little bit more powerful, you just send the VS and the Ancient Apparition up there. And let the Slaughter do his own thing up against the Clockwork. With a simple Stout Shield, an early harassment from the VS Ancient Apparition, like they can roam after maybe 1-2 minutes Dire into the game, pick. If not before that. Like this 30 seconds worth of damage into the Clockwork, maybe it'd have to be 1 minute to 2 minutes because Clockwork will still go for the lane block, but you can get that damage from the VS and AA out, so Clockwork burns through its consumables, so we can't go head-to-head with the Slaughter. And that's where I'm kind of feeling like NIP's lanes are just way too weak. Unless they switch this up and they run something like a Bane, Mirana, Earthshaker offlane, that might work. Then you put the Clockwork up on top. They'll still be very dependent on the last player from Burden United, but Ninjas in Pajamas are the ones that have to make the pick, so BU will see all of the lineup of NIP when they pick up their last hero.
10 seconds remaining.
So NIP, what's the combo with the Bane? Give me some logic here. Is it the same as what I'm thinking? No, it's not. It's just a Bane for control. Radiant the Nightmare to stop the Slaughter from chasing. And Bane, if he can... they've still got so many stuns. I don't see Fiendscript being a factor in this game. Because you've got Swap. You've got Crush. You've got Magic Missile. And you've still got one more hero to come. Now, the OD is going to be the pickup here from Ninjas in Pajamas. And in a way, this will allow... OD to gain some level of control in the mid. He has to survive the first 2 to 3 minutes. That's when Sniper will try and capitalize and have the VSAA rotate themselves in. A Brewmaster pickup. Okay. That'll be Soshka's offlane. Yeah, but you have the VS and the AA just rotate in. They land a little bit of harassment onto the OD. They just force him back. And the OD needs to hit level 4 or 5 before he can take all the mana away from the Sniper. Then he won't have to deal with Shrapnel. But he still needs to stay completely on top of the lane. Hi, that was the wrong switch. Surprise! Surprise myself.
Prepare for battle.
Anyway, yeah, the OD needs to survive. Back to where my train of thought was. The OD needs to survive in the early stages. Actually, they're going to play this very safe. Or are they? Olympus build for the mid. Era was moving towards mid. And I don't, like, they do switch themselves around. Both Olymp and Era, they do move between the top as well as the safe lane as well as the mid lane. So it could have gone either way. But it will be the OD to the mid. This OD's gonna have such a rough time. Alright, so top rune's gonna belong to Sing Sing. I think I made sure he gets a lot of money. It looks like a potential aggro tri lane. Like, Soshka's already a long way up here. My threat of the sentry ward, so... Wait, they're actually throwing their own sentry, so this camp won't spawn up. The obs are down already for NIP, so they know where BU are moving. But this is a very defensive obs ward. They're not going to see anything up on the top. As far as runes, at least they can see what's happening up here. But watching Necroman pick up... Wait, are they... No, it's just the supports moving through the lanes. But OD's going to be very happy with this. So it's the two mids to pick up the bounty runes. And just pushes the bottles forward. Again, yeah, they keep doing this. So the tangos come up a little bit later, but they make sure the sniper's able to pick up the rune. Then he picks up the tangos. So he's got a huge amount of consumables. And look at the build. How rare is it for a sniper not to build into shrapnel at the first level? This is like Sniper realizing that he doesn't want to battle the OD through mana, because he's not going to be able to. He won't have a mana pool that will allow him to do this. So he just picks up Headshot, so his physical damage directly into that OD will win the day for him. And this is also in Reason now. Like, he's making the most out of Shrapnel while he's got it. Like, it's only 50 mana, so it's not really that bad. Because he'll at least get one Shrapnel off when the OD brings him down, unless he can bring down 32, but that's pretty rough. I just like the approach coming from Necroman here. If only he could actually find more of these last hits. Right, so Seal Kid tries to move the push the Brewmaster back. Boots versus no boots. Brewmaster's going to win on that one, even though he's a big tanky kind of guy. Sing Sing. He's forced to tank damage here. Not too much, though. With the stout shield, there's still a large amount of consumables for him. He's okay with this. They should probably be giving him a little bit more space. There's a smoke over on the Vengeful Spirit. And maybe both my nuts as well as come with me are waiting until they have that level 2. And then they'll move to Limp. Move at the same time as the 2-minute rune comes in. So you've already got level 2 over on the Vengeful Spirit. I haven't managed to push the clockwork back. He is running boots. So with Chilling Touch... well done, my nuts. He can still get more damage on this clockwork. With the cogs down, it's just like, yeah, straight chip damage. I'm seeing a movement coming out from the Dire side at the moment. Actually, it's a bit of a fight. Didn't scout out the extra dot, which was Soshka. The Fissure, they could control him here. With Brain Sap as well, Fissure number one, and they keep the battle going with the first blood's in a different lane.
First blood.
The Clockwork actually picks up first blood. So the Brewmaster dies. Wait, hang on, that's not right. No, Clockwork activated the Diamond Tree. I'm tripping! The Earthshaker gets first blood. I just saw the announcement pop up at the same time. I'm like, what? No. So first blood is right. I didn't miss it. I'm not stupid, but I was at the same time. But it belongs to NIP. Protecting those rares for the moment, at least. That Troll Warlord's having a fantastic time. 14-12 on top. Obviously, he's not getting pushed back. Soshka is not involved in this whatsoever. This isn't the rotation I was expecting. They've left my nuts to farm inside the jungle, so... Okay, come with me. You're not going to reach that. The Fissure timing from the ES is perfect. Yeah, but mine not spatially goes bush. He just sits here, pulls, farms, harasses out the clockwork when he comes down, but it makes for a very ineffective rotation into mid because you want to try and smoke yourself up and you come up through the river in this direction and out through the tree line behind. So the sniper pushes the creep wave up a little bit. And then you gank onto the OD. He's got one imprisonment. And depending on the timing of where he gets that, like, he can imprison himself and dodge out the first stun, the magic missile. But normally he does things like this. So then you got a 13-second window. So you just wait for that, and then you go for it. They might wait a little bit longer, though, for level 6 on Sniper. Because then it's... I'm not even going to say it's a guarantee kill, because, again, imprisonment could end up saving you. Clockwork. If he has help, they get a kill here. And he has help. Battery assault. Not required. Just goes for the cogs. At least come with me. He's got a little bit of extra damage. He's going to try and deny himself to Roshan, but Earthshaker will be able to find himself another kill. Bane, in the meantime, though, having a little bit more trouble. The Brain Sap will keep him alive a little bit longer. And Brewmaster will drop him with the help of Sniper. So a one-for-one trade-off on the supports, both mids being committed to it. But it's the offlane for BU that gets the kill. There's much needed money into the Brewmaster, but really he needs more time on the top lane just to find farm. So without having the supports breathing down his neck. And it's going to happen again. Support TP's up on top lane. Era just gets over-aggressive on the Brewmaster, gets a bash as well with a Whirling Axes. If he gets himself another bash, he can potentially get this kill, but now he has to switch to ranged axes, and it's not enough. There were still two stick charges, which I think would have allowed enough life points to survive the last attack if he did decide to push it underneath the tower. Come with me. Vision. There he is. He's in. OD. I don't think he was looking. I really don't think he was looking. So he imprisons one. You have the Earthshaker, and what a great play! The Fissure is on the wrong side! He's got time to bottle up. Come with me. He doesn't have mana for a magic missile. In fact, they could turn on this one if they wanted to. The OD has the ulti up with another imprisonment arriving in a moment. But he's being careful of the sniper. He doesn't know if he's going to hit level 6 soon. Now the Battery Assault comes in. And Vengeful Spirit, he's way too far up. Great cogs. There's the OD ulti to ensure they come on. Come with me. But they will still lose the clockwork here. I just want to say how great the communication was from NIP. It's not over just yet, as the Nightmare will allow a setup. There's no Fissure, but they could potentially body block him. 2 more seconds until another imprisonment, and that might buy enough time. No, he's still too far away from the mana for the Fissure. So they're not going to get that opening. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Goal was to have the OD walk down the river, force player 1 and player 2 to both come down with him, and then all of a sudden you put the Fissure block and they can't walk after the OD anymore. That was the goal. When the clockwork rotates up, then they're thinking, okay, now we can find more blood. And they really could have. But the trade-off didn't really work for him, so not as joyful. One person is still not involved. He's already got... Actually, he hasn't picked up a creep. He's only just got the helm of the Dominator. Hasn't been used, as you can see, not on cooldown. And he'll probably just grab Hellbear. He'll prefer to have the Troll. It's easier to stack with the Troll. But these Ancients are going to be a priority thing for him. With the Helm of the Dominator as well, he can just go in towards Roshan. So Alpha Wolf or something that can help him do. Or, yeah, just stack the Ancients. That's all he's searching for. But be careful about keeping that bottle on the ground. I think Earthshaker reminded him that that bottle was just sitting behind the tower. Top lane, Nightmare. And this will set up now for range into melee Whirling Axes. Still needs a bash. Actually, no, they don't. With the brain sap and the range damage, it's more than enough. The Ancient Apparition's also going to die inside the Radiant Jungle. Looks like a simple walk up and kill him. Was it a haste rune? We had an Earthshaker with a haste rune. Nope, so it wasn't a clockwork. He just must have got him in the fog of war. We are still during our nighttime phase. So vision is pretty sparse. That's how come with me got so close on the OD before in the mid lane. He's been such a nuisance as well. They realize the sniper's not winning the lane as hard as they want to, which means OD's getting momentum. They'll struggle to kill him at the moment, which is the reason why now they commit 3 heroes, the 2 supports and the sniper. He's got DD, the shrapnel will give him the vision, but we can't get in range. The Fissure block will come in, a little bit of orb damage. Actually, he doesn't even have the arcane orb leveled up, but it doesn't matter. Come with me, has to deny himself to the Ancients. Use the Fog of War, not gonna happen. Salves up, the Clockwork, Rocket, easy kaka. Death in a can. So 8 minutes in, NIP. Rolling with the punches, and everything BU keeps throwing at him. Not really working, so they're gonna try and throw something different, the curveball. Take the Sniper and the Ancient Apparition up towards the top, and they're looking for the Troll Warlord. This one should be a little bit easier. There's no Drunken Haste, so they try and use the Shrapnel instead. But he's got the mischance, assassination, they got the kill. The Cold Feet's also going to trigger, and that's a big one. He's worth a lot of experience, but on bottom lane, I think Sing Sing is practically dead. Hook shot, off cooldown. There's your first Fissure into the Battery Assault. They just try and hold him here. OD's still got imprisonment, so they can set up for this one. Yeah, they will do so. Cogs are back off cooldown, and they'll hold him. And there's nowhere for Sing Sing to go. Trapped in an electrical death. We go 3-7 now on the board. Trade-off for trade-off. The solos for the solos. And the mid-solos, the safe lane solos for the safe lane solo. The mid-solos are the ones being involved. Earthshaker. With the assassination, Earthshaker should be really careful. He's already dropping very low. And, well, he could with a stun. Come with me. He doesn't have a magic missile. Great TP out. Troll Warlord kill off the Brewmaster in the meantime on the top lane. Looks like a bit of a assist coming in with the hook shot. But after picking that kill up, he's going to go jungle. He's got the helm of the Dominator, so he just wants to walk through his jungle and just keep farming that one up and give the top lane to the Clockwork. So this allows Clockwork to farm up to getting his Blade Mail. Which basically means Sniper is going to start killing himself unless he builds a BKB. Same for the VS, same for the Slaughter. The Slaughter doesn't want to do that. Like the arm choice I was saying before was going to be something like a Vanguard. Up against no D, I don't know if Slaughter's really going to be feeling as confident with that. Just start off with a Blink Dagger. Jump in, get the kill, move on. That should be the goal. We're going to battle for top. Fissure. The initial stun wouldn't have done enough, and the Observer Ward sitting on the dire side of the river is what allowed the Sniper to see that coming. That just means they have to give up the rune. But it's a double damage rune coming into Bane. That's not as bad. Is that Treads for... Yeah, it's Treads for Era, in fact. Kind of surprising, but he went to the jungle. Wait, hang on. So he's building a Maelstrom? Middle lane. Goodbye, Sniper. Nightmare. I love how Bane also gets the Arcane proc. The Essence Aura. Love it. Clockwork started in the meantime up on top lane. Brewmaster split. Nope. Just done Wave of Terror and Clap doing the work. Impressive for a Clockwork to die when he's got Tranquils as well as the Blade Mail. He had to be low before that started.
Yes.
I think OD's dead. I'm certain OD is dead. I saw the AA ulti coming in, realized, wait, Sing Sing's moved towards the middle lane. He hit the Blink Dagger timing. So he went directly for the Blink, and that's what it's all about. Just jump in, don't let NIP react. And then you got to keep doing this. You can't just get one pick and be happy with that. You have to find more, and that's what looking towards bottom lane. Using the Vortex with the Shrapnel combination. They're not going to kill off Earthshaker, but with that damage, it's going to be enough to force him back. And Era, at the same time he went in for Roshan, come with me, scouted him out. He found an Alpha Wolf, thought he had enough damage, and he did have enough damage to kill off Roshan. But with the pressure starting to mount, yeah, it looks like Slaughter again finding another kill. This time they do use the Brewmaster split. Well, I was too busy watching Roshan. But Sing Sing pushing everyone back. So with Clockwork dead, again, the Blade Mail gets even more delayed. He's got the most expensive part of it left to purchase. We're gonna go on mid. There's your stun. Crush. Ice Blast. Holy crap. They're getting schooled. Like, BU are getting so schooled right now. There's at least one opening here for Era. Come with me. He does have a Magic Missile stun. The Chilling Touch. Potentially they could turn him with a Shrapnel. Era, they need more of a slowdown. OD just locks it, does the imprisonment. Takes out my nuts. And forces him back. Now, for everything that's still going on, for all these great, like, roaming ganks are coming out from Sing Sing, he's finding openings, we're getting Mask of Madness over on Sniper. The Brewmaster's not looking great, but he's getting closer and closer to the Blink Dagger. He's at least able to do something during the fights when he's got some teammates to help him out. Like, he's about to do on the top lane. Sing Sing just TP'd up here. So they're battling for the last hit. Soshka, wow, that Echo Slam. Middle is heavy and Sing Sing. He's wanting to wait for the secondary TP in, but he got the timing wrong. So OD imprisons over on Sing Sing, denies up the tower and the Earthshaker. Waited out. Now he can go for the Fitch, but the assassination. He should have just thrown it. The Nightmare coming out from Bane was already too late. Now, in fact, he blocks the hook shot. This allows the Brewmaster to get away. The Ice Blast is on the way here. Sing Sing, one more orb. The rockets fly. Something. They can't reach him. He denies. Nope. He blinks and runs. On 36 life points. What level is that rocket? Radiant's level 2. Bottom tower is under attack. They can see him. But getting that prediction rocket is going to be so hard. But it's worth a go. They scattered it out. Sing Sing's fine. Roshan's not, though, with Era. The Alpha Wolf is going to try and turn, but Ancient Apparition throws out the Ice Blast. And my nuts get chilly on top of the Troll Warlord. Even finding a DD rune. The Earthshaker. Well, he might feel confident enough to hold the Ancient Apparition in position for maybe 2-3 seconds, but beyond that, You're not going to find any other confidence. He'll just drop very quickly. And now it's going to be BU's turn. I said they're a very quick Roshan team. With 3 points up in the wave of terror, they had to trigger. Oh, Clark! Whoa, he's in! Soshka has a split inside the pit. The Fissure also splits him up a little bit more. The Clockwork's going to die very quickly. But Roshan clamping him. They had to smoke. It protects them from Roshan beating into him. Because there's no other heroes. They're not revealing themselves. So Roshan's not going to try and clap him again. Not anytime soon while the Brueling sends the Bane into the air. Where's your extra help? The Sniper as well as Kalmi are locked in the river. Ira comes in. One attack and Kalmi will die. Nice Fissure controls up the Sniper. And now BU. They got a great start by killing off that Clockwork. He did jump in crazily with the cog push. But NIP waited out perfectly. They realized the Brewmaster split's gone. There's no way the BU were going to go for Roshan. They smoked up, so yeah, NIP went a little bit blind for a moment. They didn't have any observables there anyway. So they waited for the intelligence to know where BU was. And it came at the perfect time when the troll ulti was down. That was when Bane went up and they saw it dissipate. So Troll picks up the Aegis, the Immortal. They'll take a really good fight. And the net worth just swinging back and forward right now. But the bigger problem right now for BU is the fact that the two top net worths belong to the OD as well as the Troll Warlord. So you got your front brawler, and you've also got the OD, who is going to make the Brewmaster a non-factor at one point. Because you're still seeing Soshka. While he's a very experienced Brewmaster player, we're not seeing him with the Blink Dagger. This is the downside about running a hero on the off lane that can't really flash farm a jungle. Sing Sing, dead. Battery Assault, Cogs. Oh, okay. They must have been really worried he was going to escape from that to commit the Fiend's Grip. That's a decent cooldown time. But a kill is a kill. Kaomi with the Invis Rune. There's nice blast coming to mid. But they need someone sitting right here to make the most out of it. And at that time, you've already seen him move back. OD continuing his farm. Running ahead of Midas build on the OD. So really building to be a high item progression hero into the mid game. The Fissure, just trying to stop the Sniper from beating into him. Assassination, imprison him. Perfect. Perfect. This OD pick is actually working wonderfully. I love it up against the Sniper. Saving, if that was any other hero as a mid solo, the Clockwork would be dead right now. But they're able to force BU to move to different targets with that imprisonment. So defensive ones during the fight are just as good as the aggressive ones, giving the extra intelligence over to the OD. Hit uphill. Yep. There you go. A little bit of encouragement. He's good. Looks like a Radiant Creep has turned to the dark side of the map. He is the stack creep that's been taken by the Troll Warlord. At least, is that right? 60 seconds on cooldown. Yeah, it's got to be his. There's no other Helm of the Dominator on the field. So yeah, it's got to be his. He just took it a while ago. That's the Troll... Yeah, he must have just been doing one of the stacks. Alright, so what's that line for? That's come with me drawing it. I don't know if he's drawing saying NIP are coming down this way. Because if that's what he's doing, or that's what he thinks, he's 100% right. Because NIP are moving down the mid. They're not smoked up, but they are out of vision. They're using the Fog of War beautifully. There is a Radiant Observer Wall that's watching also Clockwork pick up that DD rune. And they want to defend middle lane. There's no Blink Dagger on the Earthshaker. But what he was hoping for was just someone to linger around here and only had one choice to back up that direction, then just take that choice away from them. Defense and imprisonment to save some life. Noob. Just deny up that mid tower. Dire's middle tower has been Troll Warlord. It actually helped out by turning on his ultimate. Bringing assassinations fly. Clockwork. That's a little hookshot. Sing Sing gets the amplification back over on the Clockwork. With the Fissure arriving with the rockets. Yeah, you got no hookshot in for this. What you do have is Soshka. Nope. Era missing on the range rolling axe. They found another opening. That's the OT. That's the biggest one of all. He has to self-imprison himself. There's no other choice. I may as well just throw the ulti. The primal split comes off already. And OD, no 4-staff, no BKB. He can't get himself away. The troll can't help out either. It is a 1-for-1 trade-off, but they're about to make it 2 of that ice blast. It's going to come from the clockwork, but nothing more. And the Brewlings are going to wear off. They do find another opening, which is the troll. But I don't think... Okay, yeah, there's a, it's a 4-on-1. It's an opening. The crush comes in, the amplification as well, but they got hit by the rain, by the melee whirling axes. They had a lot of missed chances, and Mind Nut's on the run. The Clockwork Rocket in 5 seconds' time. The Fissure, off target. So where's Clockwork? Have a guess. It's coming in. It's coming in. It's coming. But it doesn't hit Mind Nut's. 132 life points. Yeah, he would have died. He would have died also with a reduction. He would have died.
Do it with flair.
Sorry, 13-11. This game proving to be a lot more of a back and forth kind of thing. As my Clockwork couldn't hit his mark. But it seems this mark shall be connected on. Is this level 1? It's level 1. So do your math right there. I think he's okay. Yeah, he's okay. Connects, but no kill. Needed more levels. Needed a lot more levels.
Illusion.
Trying to actually see maybe 10 minutes forward in this game. Like the sniper's finding damage. Let's just look at BU for a moment. So the sniper's building into a Yasha. Potentially SMY, more than likely Manta. Well, the mana's not really going to help him during the team fights beyond the stats. Sing Sing needs the BKB. There's no other choice here. In fact, I kind of also think that the sniper needs to find his own BKB. It's back to that point of the Clockwork with when he turns the Blade Mail on. There's nothing the sniper can do against him. He's just going to get hit by the battery assault. So because of that, he needs to have his BKB. But, yeah. It's going to take him a long time to get to that point. Especially when Sing Sing is taking a lot of the farm in the jungle. Mind you, observed farm as well. So they know what he's doing. And Mind Nut's, at least he's running ahead of Midas, so these levels, which I was talking about before, he's going to find them. And eventually he'll find his Agon Imceptor the longer this game goes on. But NIP, they don't need to keep this game going on too long. Are you still running around with an OD Troll as well as a Clockwork who's on his way towards an Agon Imceptor? So the Clockwork is pretty tanky when he jumps him. It'll take a large commitment from BU to kill him off. Either that or they're all just there at the perfect time with Chilling Touch. But NIP, it's jump in, it's burst damage, it's control. They can fight once this BKB's up for the Troll Warlord, because BU, they don't really have any major control. The Troll, the Slaughter can't stand on the front lines in order to get these, like, bash procs, and he's not going to attack fast enough to say the bash is going to work. It's not as though he's got someone like a Troll Warlord giving him Battle Trance. Like, that would make a big difference. And once the OD's got his own BKB, the Brewmaster will be a nothing. Because you got orb damage coming from the OD, and he'd be like just bursting everyone down. The VS and the Ancient Apparition are food. In Radiant's fact, if this game goes late, is under attack. Like the VS is saving someone and then dead. Where the Ancient Apparition, he's one of these guys where he can be nowhere near the fight. He can leave defensive vortexes so the team can fall back. He can give Chilling Touch every single time. And he can throw his ulti, which he needs to be back for anyway, so the radius is bigger. But I almost don't want him to be anywhere near the fight. Just throw the ulti at the right time.
Do it with flair.
Radiant's bottom tower is under
attack. NIP are ready to fight this. They're using the Clockwork as bait. He's got an Ogre Club on him as well now. Is there any vision for this? The range whirling axes? That was the first thing that came over towards Sing Sing. Fissure turns on the ulti. Nice swap out, gonna go into the split, but the OD comes in, and they're focusing down the Fire Brewling. He's already on the sidelines. Go through the Storm One. The Assassination Bane, where's your Nightmare Brain Sap? Something! Used an ability. He couldn't. The Earth Brewling's the last one left alive. The Clockwork misses the hook shot. So TP successfully out for Sing Sing. And Kalmi just trying to hold Ear in position. And in fact, with the sniper, they're turning back into this one. The Ice Blast is perfect. The OD returns it, however. But NIP, they're committed way too far into this fight. Sing Sing might have still died, but... Man. I don't know. Like, Bane died for no real good. The Brewmaster split came, and it was kind of a non-factor. And NIP, they chase this. This happened to them last night up against Team Empire. It was a different case in that game because they were looking. Yeah, stop Dyer's being a dick, Sing. I see that. It was different in that case because NIP thought they could take a melee Rax, and they really could, and they couldn't back up in time, and they did a semi-turn, and it wasn't quite right. In this case, they didn't turn, yet they knew they'd lost the fight. When that Ice Blast connected, they were dead. Because the sniper just ran in, dished out all the damage he wanted to, and killed them all. Obviously, there was a lot of other help going into that, but I just was really surprised how ineffective NIP was in that fight. Really, really, really surprised. So Roshan's up in 52 seconds. NIP have to make sure the BU do not get this, or else that next team fight is just dead to them. OG's going to get connected on by the Ice Blast, but it's merely chip damage right now. It is level 11. But it doesn't have the... actually, it will really soon. A 5-1-3 on the Ancient Apparition. That last fight, I didn't realize just how far it injected money into him. He's been running the mines, which has already been fantastic, but an Aghanim Scepter and 250 gold. What's the sniper got? What's over on the courier? Now, it looks like it's an earn start for Come With Me. Or an earn finish for Come With Me. Actually, no, it's not. He doesn't have the recipe. That's a problem. The one thing they do have is slightly on his way to a BKB. The full Vlad's over on the Brewmaster, and he's also starting up on his BKB. So it's the Earthshaker who got his Blink Dagger. So with ES with this, BU's next team fight should not be as good. Like, it was still kind of crazy, because NIP blew everything. Like, the hook shot was well off target. The Echo Slam was a non-factor. The OD ulti... and Bane... he was dead at the start. Like, no Nightmare defense. The Assassination, sure, it's going to do a lot of damage to you, but at least try and brain zap something and attempt to survive. It's a level 2 Assassination. A level 4 brain zap should be our deal with that. With the life points he had, of course. Is under attack. So pushed out to the T1 tower on bot. Clockwork. Do they have any vision of this? Even if they had wards, it doesn't protect them from the smoke. Nice aggressive ward down from BU. So they see everything. The rocket flies. Scouts out both Soshka as well as my nuts. But Singh and Kawami are waiting for this. The Chilling Touch bonus on Singh, and he gets a double clap. Perfect as well. Follow up into the Brewmaster split. Bane again, dead before the fight even begins. The Clockwork will drop as well. Get the hell out of there. The Assassination will connect on the Earthshaker. It's scattered the fact the OD was TPing. Sing Sing, blink clap, on. He misfingered his keyboard right then. The click was on the wrong button, I think. Because that crush could have come out instantly. It was off cooldown when he blinked himself in. And that would have been a threefer. Either way, I said before, NIP can't allow BU to take this Roshan. Because by doing so, they now win the next fight. It's almost a guarantee that they win the next fight. The Aegis Immortal into Sing Sing here. He's going to be even more aggressive on the map. The sniper doesn't really need much to keep going, but he's up to 2,000 gold. I am still assuming BKB. I highly doubt the Desolator. Fissure. Are they going for this? No. No. The Troll Warlord doesn't have a way just to get himself in. He didn't buy a Blink Dagger. Instead, he bought the BKB and still just walking around with a casual Yasha in the helm of the Dominator. No Troll has been converting that into the full Satanic effect. It's like the very last item that you change. As a Troll, it's just perfect for grabbing the creep. It's nice damage, it's good armor, and it's great lifesteal. Everything a good Troll needs. And that's the last thing he needs, that Blink Dagger. I mean, the next thing he needs, not the last thing he needs. Get Ancient Apparition in a great spot. With an Aghanim Scepter, he could literally AFK here and just throw out Ice Blast after Ice Blast after Ice Blast. I think that he wants to join the rest of his team. Do we have smoke on them? Not right now. But you just got double BKBs. So you got two 10-second BKBs for BU during the next engagement, and an Aegis the Immortal over on the Slaughter. Now, they're going to reveal the fact, like, Ilga 6, he moved up so quickly to try and find a hero, but NIP backed out so early. They backed out before BU even arrived for their T1 tower. OD. He really has no choice for this. Because the amount of damage the Ice Blast does to him this early on, and there's no mech, like, it's not like the old days of the OD where you could use Buckler and that would trigger your Essence Aura. Oh, nice. Clockwork. That Invis Rune's going to do him some work until, well, actually, no. Vayne, so much trouble. He at least got his Brain Zap off this time. The Urshaker could have bought some time with another Fissure, but he couldn't see the right line where he could get the Bane out of there. Even if it was a Fissure so he can Brain Zap Nightmare 1, that could have helped. And he had a Blink Dagger to get himself into the perfect spot too. Alright, NIP, they're not displaying that wonderful team fight I saw last night up against Team Empire. They may have been underestimating BU. Like, Burden United have played a fantastic game today. They're moving aggressively, their drafts have been wonderfully done by my nuts. Alright, that's an aggressive TP out, and a very quick blink away. That costs Sing Sing nothing. Like, what, 150 mana? He's still got Aegis the Immortal, he doesn't care at the moment. I still got another 2 minutes left on that Aegis. So Sing's gonna go back and heal up, and then sprint down to the bottom lane. And that should be where they push. In 2 minutes, that bottom wave should be able to reach the tier 2 tower. They're actually gonna fight into this. The Aegis is still up. I don't know why NIP are here. The Echo Slam's gonna drop. The Brewmaster swapped out by Come With Me. Saved at the last moment. He's gonna blink, clap, and in fact he just blink splits. Era's down for the count. You're gonna go for your Fiend Script, but as I said before, the Bane pick doesn't make any sense because you're just gonna get disabled straight away. There's too many disables on the field. Blink down, the Cogs push it back, he TP'd out. He's not there. So Sing Sing can just chase somebody else, but NIP, this game is completely out of control. Completely. It was like the same position we were at before when Sing Sing had his PL in game number one. You just look at it, and you don't understand where they can find the team fight, and you also don't understand why NIP was trying to fight that. Like, they've already lost their outer towers apart from that tier 2 on bottom. Are they looking to try and engage on a BU? Because they did over on Brewmaster, but they couldn't even save him. I mean, they couldn't even kill him. Come With Me just came in, swapped him out, and you're good to go. And you can expect BU to just be 5-manning at the moment, because you still had the Aegis the Immortal. But this Aegis is going to time out in, what, 30 seconds? So NIP fought into an Aegis, they fought on the wrong side of the map, and they couldn't get their initial kill, which was the Brewmaster. VS doesn't have a range for that swap. If Kalmi had something like a 4-star for a Blink Dagger, then maybe he'd make it. In fact, he would have made it if he had a Blink Dagger. And even look at OD. I'm surprised he didn't get something like a 4-star. Because I would have preferred to see the stats out from a 4-star. I think it'll still do the same job as what he's looking for out of the Blink Dagger. But it really does feel like NIP doesn't have confidence to get the initial jump. Like, you got a Clockwork with an Aghanim Scepter as well. Like, you should have all the confidence in the world to get that first jump. But when you can't even take out tier 1 towers, like, there's one tier 1 tower dropped. And that was a trade drop. So NIP going down quickly. Very, very quickly. The troll's still number one as far as net worth. It's not really paying off during the fights, but he's still there. They still have a lot to play with NIP. They just gotta stop getting hit by the combo. And if they can do that, life should be a lot better for them. But then, if that's gonna happen, they need to fight from a better position. And that, I think, is also the reason why Mynuts grabs this gem over on the Ancient Apparition. NIP need vision, and right now they're relying on rockets to do so from the Clockwork. They have an Observer Ward nicely inside the Radiant Jungle. They got one watching over the Pit of Roshan. This is mainly also to see if there's anyone that's gonna flank up through their Incoming. Secret shop. They do have one other creep that's just standing here, the one range creep, which was being used to stack up the Ancients. So there are other ways that NIP can detect them. But you look at this, and you know Sing Sing's bait. Like, you just know it. So you don't want to fight into it. You only want to fight on top of your tier 3 towers. Like, that's all NIP can do. In fact, that's all NIP should do. Play exactly like Burden United did yesterday in map number one. Era. Game number one. Era's gonna BKB to get out of this one. How many seconds is that thing down to? That's his 8-second charge. He's still gonna get caught. The amplification's on him, so they have perfect vision of Era. He doesn't have high movement speed either. Those Storm Brulings moving so quickly. It should get the pickup, and it does. And they want Era. The troll is the bigger pickout. And Sing Sing just walks up, but they didn't do any damage. It's not like a Yule Scepter, which will do the damage when you hit the ground. So they need to be on top of it. There's no buybacks Radiant's from anybody. So if they did kill him, it would have been real trouble. But they don't, so it's buying more time. That Midas of Limp is still keeping him in this game, as far as Arden progression goes. The Earthshaker has his blink, that's great. Bane, Sacrificial Lamb. I'd almost like to see the Clockwork just pick up a casual Bracer at this point, because he needs just a little bit more life points to survive this. He's got 1600, which is great, but maybe he's also trying to look for his own BKB. Okay, Slam Initiation, they got Sing. That's going to give a little bit of breathing room right now for NIP. And they're going to try and capitalize. Finally, get some injection of money coming into them. They're 5 towers behind at the moment. And the funny thing is, though, if you look at it from that perspective, at the experience perspective, it all goes the way of Burden United. If you look at it from the goal perspective, B is only going to maybe a 2. Earthshaker's dead. Assassination takes him out perfectly. I think the OD was trying to get in range from the imprisonment. Clock just hook shots away. Yeah, but back to my point. If you look at it, there was only a 2.5k gold advantage for BU. Once you can bring down all the tier 1 and the tier 2 towers. Which doesn't really seem like much. But that's still looking at some really big items coming in for NIP. If they can just bring down these buildings. But they can't find the openings for it. They're getting force pack. Roshan's got a quick spawn time. It's within the first minute. Sniper. Well, Sniper's dead for a very long time. This should just be a straight push up. Actually, it should be a push up hit. Yeah, they're already making their way for it. Buyback's available for both OD as well as Troll. So if they do push for the mid, they're not going to take it. And in fact, who else they managed to find? It's a trade-off. The Ancient Apparition to drop. They give the Gem of True Sight over. In fact, yeah, the ping's coming out saying the Gem has dropped here. Seal Kid has to grab it. Now they're going to give it to the Clockwork. He's tankier. Hook shots himself away from Sing Sing. They saw him run past the Dire Creep Wave. Hence the reason they got out in time. Oh man, Sing, come with me. He's up a long way. Career right behind him with a wave of terror. Swap him down. Nice hook shot. The magic missile will still connect, but the Fissure's there to block him. And come with me. Oh, there's not enough intelligence in that OD to drop the ulti to get the kill instantly on come with me. And they need more damage. The Shrine will scout out Roshan. And Sing wants to go for it. And he can do it. So Sing will do the tanking. Again, triggering out that defensive and then amplifying him up. And Roshan, negative 21 armor, and he can't hit Jack. Down for the count. She's also on the deck. That one can be taken by Sing Sing. And the Aegis Immortal into the hands of the sniper. So it's BU's turn to force things. That Assault Cuirass is still taking some time for Sing Sing. Is he just left on the ground, or is he just not had his money? Yeah, he just hasn't purchased anything. Thought he had more cash. Obviously not. NIP only have one buyback for this fight. And you can see how Limp approaches. It's like, I need to be able to survive. He's either getting a Lincoln Sphere or a Scythe of Ice. Either way, it's going to help. That Ultimate Orb will get it for him. But he needs more stats coming into this fight. There's just no other choice. He actually does need the Scythe. There is no alternative as well. Because without it, you're not going to have your control over on that Slaughter when he jumps in. So if you can catch him up before he BKBs, that's the biggest kill you can get. It would literally crush BU. And Limp is the only one they're exposing. They're keeping the Earthshaker back so he's able to blink into the Echo Slam. And then you can just hookshot the Clockwork in when the time is right. He does have TP available. He's just farming the Radiant Jungle at the moment. Might almost be worth grabbing the creep wave here and then dragging it down to the camp. Just stalls up the push and forces BU to look behind themselves all the time. They kind of are already. I think the rocket's been flying up towards mid, so BU do know the clockwork's on the other side of the map. BU also realize that with the vision from the shrapnel and the range of the sniper, they can just slowly chip away at the towers. And patience coming from BU. I don't know if it's really worthwhile patience, because they're not getting anything for this. Okay, the ice blast's going to slow down the push from Clockwork, but now that's not available for the fight, and they're TPing back. So the ice blast being released is a non-factor in the fight. That Fissure well off target, and they're going to let the ES die. And rightly so. There was no reason to try and stand and save him. The ice blast coming back off cooldown at 18 seconds. The tier 3 tower's already dropped, and you got a creep wave pushing in. So up they come. Look at Decker, man. Doesn't even want to wait. He's going to get enfeebled up a little bit. So the damage output of the sniper is no longer really good. Because he doesn't have a lot of damage, but he has no damage item buffs, really. Nightmare Row from the Brewmaster. What, are we going to go into a Fiend's Crypt here? Yep, yeah, we are. OD, got to drop the ulti. Like, right now, anyway. They're all on top of him before he ends up dying. The Clockwork got a great hookshot at the back end. Actually taking out the Ancient Apparition. He's right on top of him. The Clamp will come out with the assassination. AA, he's kept alive. Komi swapped him away just in cases. There's a triple kill for Necromant. Finally, Limp will drop the ulti, but it's too little too late. He's lost so many of his teammates. And remember, they're still running around. There's that cheese, even with a bash from Sing Sing. I think it's GG. It's an ultra kill, in fact. It's a rampage in for Burden United. The burden has been lifted. Remove the stone of shame and attach the stone of triumph. A fantastic 2-0 victory in for Burden United. Rez, I am almost certain, was lost this day. If I look over, yep, holy Hannah, they were lost. 14% of people bet on Burden. 14% of people. Over 100,000 items were actually bet on this game, and 14%, congratulations to those who are walking home with Arcanas. Good luck to them. If you want to keep watching Burden, check out the ESL 1 stream. You can find the details over on joinedit.com. Capitalist is casting that one. He is awaiting them, and they will go up against BBC. But you can stay tuned on this live stream. NIP have a double header where they'll be going up against the Russians. Hellraisers will be up right now up against NIP. So stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. Chasing and Bane, if he can. Well, they've still got so many stuns. I don't see Fiend's Grip being a factor in this game. Because you've got Swap, you've got Crush, you've got Magic Missile, and you've still got one more hero to come. Now, the OD is going to be the pickup here from Ninjas in Pajamas. And in a way, this will allow OD to gain some level of control in the mid. He has to survive the first 2 to 3 minutes. That's when Sniper will try and capitalize and have the VSAA rotate themselves in. A Brewmaster pickup. Okay. That'll be Soshka's offlane. Yeah, but you have the VS and the AA just rotate in. They land a little bit of harassment onto the OD. They just force him back. And the OD needs to hit level 4 or 5 before he can take all the mana away from the Sniper. Then he won't have to deal with Shrapnel. But he still needs to stay completely on top of the lane. Hi. That was the wrong switch. Surprise! Surprise myself.
Prepare for battle.
Anyway, the OD needs to survive. Back to where my train of thought was. The OD needs to survive in the early stages. Actually, they're going to play this very safe. Or are they? Limp is built for the mid. Era was moving towards mid. And I don't, like, they do switch themselves around. Both Limp and Era, they do move between the top as well as the safe lane as well as the mid lane. So it could have gone either way. But it will be the OD to the mid. This is just going to have such a rough time. Alright, so top rune's going to belong to Sing Sing. I think I made sure he gets a lot of money. It looks like a potential aggro tri lane. Like, Soshka's already a long way up here. My threat of the sentry ward, so... Wait, they're actually throwing their own sentry, so this camp won't spawn up. The obs are down already for NIPs. They know where BU are moving. But this is a very defensive obs ward. They're not going to see anything up on the top. As far as runes, at least they can see what's happening up here. But watching Necroman pick up... Wait, are they... No, it's just the supports moving through the lanes. But OD's going to be very happy with this. So it's the two mids to pick up the bounty runes. And just pushes the bottles forward. Again, yeah, they keep doing this. So the tangos come up a little bit later, but they make sure the sniper's able to pick up the rune. Then he picks up the tangos. So he's got a huge amount of consumables. And look at the build. How rare is it for a sniper not to build into shrapnel at the first level? This is like sniper realizing that he doesn't want to battle the OD through mana, because he's not going to be able to. He won't have a mana pool that will allow him to do this. So he just picks up headshot, so his physical damage directly into that OD will win the day for him. And this is also in reason now. Like he's making the most out of shrapnel while he's got it. Like, it's only 50 mana, so it's not really that bad. Because he'll at least get one shrapnel off when the OD brings him down, unless he can bring down 32, but that's pretty rough. I just like the approach coming from Necroman here. If only he could actually find more of these last hits. Right, so Seal Kid tries to move the push the Brewmaster back. Boots versus no boots. Brewmaster's going to win on that one, even though he's a big tanky kind of guy. Sing Sing. He's forced to tank damage here. Not too much, though. With the stout shield, there's still a large amount of consumables for him. He's okay with this. They should probably be giving him a little bit more space. There's a smoke over on the Vengeful Spirit. And maybe both my nuts as well as come with me are waiting until they have that level 2. And then they'll move to limp. Move at the same time as the 2-minute rune comes in. So you've already got level 2 over on the Vengeful Spirit. They haven't managed to push the clockwork back. He is running boots. So with Chilling Touch... well done, my nuts. He can still get more damage on this clockwork. With the cogs down, it's just like, yeah, straight chip damage. I'm seeing a movement coming out from the Dire side at the moment. Actually, it's a bit of a fight. Didn't scout out the extra dot, which was Zoshka. The Fissure, they could control him here. With Brain Sap as well, Fissure number one, and they keep the battle going with the first bloods in a different lane.
First blood.
The Clockwork actually picks up first blood. So the Brewmaster dies. Wait, hang on, that's not right. No, Clockwork activated the Diamond Tree. I'm tripping! The Earthshaker gets first blood. I just saw the announcement pop up at the same time. I'm like, what? No. So first blood is right. I didn't miss it. I'm not stupid, but I was at the same time. But it belongs to NIP. Protecting those rares for the moment, at least. That Troll Warlord's having a fantastic time. 14-12 on top. Obviously, he's not getting pushed back. Soshka is not involved in this whatsoever. This isn't the rotation I was expecting. They've left my nuts to farm inside the jungle, so... Okay, come with me. You're not going to reach that. The Fissure timing from the ES is perfect. Yeah, but mine not spatially goes bush. He just sits here, pulls, farms, harasses out the clockwork when he comes down, but it makes for a very ineffective rotation into mid because you want to try and smoke yourself up and you come up through the river in this direction and out through the tree line behind. So the sniper pushes the creep wave up a little bit. And then you gank onto the OD. He's got one imprisonment. And depending on the timing of where he gets that, like, he can imprison himself and dodge out the first stun, the magic missile. But normally he does things like this. So then you got a 13-second window. So you just wait for that, and then you go for it. They might wait a little bit longer, though, for level 6 on Sniper. Because then it's... I'm not even going to say it's a guarantee kill, because, again, imprisonment could end up saving you. Clockwork. If he has help, they get a kill here. And he has help. Battery assault. Not required. Just goes for the cogs. At least come with me. He's got a little bit of extra damage. He's going to try and deny himself to Roshan, but Earthshaker will be able to find himself another kill. Vayne, in the meantime, though, having a little bit more trouble. The Brain Sap will keep him alive a little bit longer. And Brewmaster will drop him with the help of Sniper. So a one-for-one trade-off on the supports. Both mids being committed to it. But it's the offlane... for BU that gets the kill. There's much needed money into the Brewmaster, but really, he needs more time on the top lane just to find farm. So without having the supports breathing down his neck. And it's going to happen again. Support TP's up on top lane. Era just gets over-aggressive on the Brewmaster, gets a bash as well with a Whirling Axes. If he gets himself another bash, he can potentially get this kill, but now he had to switch to ranged axes, and it's not enough. There were still two stick charges, which I think would have allowed enough life points to survive the last attack if he did decide to push it underneath the tower. Come with me. Vision. There he is. He's in. OD. I don't think he was looking. I really don't think he was looking. So he imprisons one. You have the Earthshaker, and what a great play! The Fissure's on the wrong side! He's got time to bottle up. Come with me. He doesn't have mana for a magic missile. In fact, they could turn on this one if they wanted to. The OD has the ulti up with another imprisonment arriving in a moment. He's being careful of the sniper. He doesn't know if he's going to hit level 6 soon. Now the battery assault comes in. And Vengeful Spirit, he's way too far up. Great cogs. There's the OD ulti to ensure the kill on Come With Me. They will still lose the clockwork here. I just want to say how great the communication was from NIP. It's not over just yet, as the Nightmare will allow a setup. There's no Fissure, but they could potentially body block him. 2 more seconds until another imprisonment, and that might buy enough time. No, he's still too far away from the mana for the Fissure. So they're not going to get that opening. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Goal was to have the OD walk down the river, force player 1 and player 2 to both come down with him. And then all of a sudden you put the Fissure block and they can't walk after the OD anymore. That was the goal. When the clockwork rotates up, then they're thinking, okay, now we can find more blood. And they really could have. But the trade-off didn't really work for him, so not as joyful. One person is still not involved. He's already got... He hasn't picked up the creep. He's only just got the helm of the Dominator. Hasn't been used, actually. BU were going to go for Roshan. They smoked up, so yeah, NIP went a little bit blind for a moment. They didn't have any Observer Wards there anyway. So they waited for the intelligence to know where BU was. And it came at the perfect time when the troll ulti was down. That was when Bane went up and they saw it dissipate. So troll picks up the Aegis the Immortal. They'll take a really good fight. And the net worth just swinging back and forward right now. But the bigger problem right now for BU is the fact that the two top net worths belong to the OD as well as the troll warlord. So you got your front brawler and you've also got the OD who is going to make the Brewmaster a non-factor at one point. Because you're still seeing Soshka. While he's a very experienced Brewmaster player, we're not seeing him with the Blink Dagger. This is the downside about running a hero on the offlane that can't really flash farm a jungle. Sing Sing, dead. Battery Assault, Cogs. Oh, okay. They must have been really worried he was going to escape from that to commit the Fiend's Grip. That's a decent cooldown time. But a kill is a kill. Come with me with the Invis rune. There's nice blast coming to mid. But they need someone sitting right here to make the most out of it. And at that time, you've already seen him move back. OD continuing his farm. Running ahead of Midas build on the OD. So really building to be a high item progression hero into the mid game. The Fissure, just trying to stop the sniper from beating into him. Assassination, imprison him. Perfect. Perfect. This OD pick is actually working wonderfully. I love it up against the sniper. Saving if that was any other hero as a mid solo, the clockwork attack would be dead right now. But they're able to force BU to move to different targets with that imprisonment. So defensive ones during the fight are just as good as the aggressive ones, giving the extra intelligence over to the OD. Hit uphill. Yep. There you go. A little bit of encouragement, he's good. Looks like a Radiant Creep has turned to the dark side of the map. He is the stack creep that's been taken by the Troll Warlord. At least, is that right? 60 seconds on cooldown. Yeah, it's got to be his. There's no other Helm of the Dominator on the field, so yeah, it's got to be his. He just took it a while ago. That's the Troll... Yeah, he must have just been doing one of the stacks. Alright, so what's that line for? That's Come With Me drawing it. I know if he's drawing saying NIP are coming down this way. Because if that's what he's doing, well, that's what he thinks, he's 100% right. Because NIP are moving down the mid. They're not smoked up, but they are out of vision. They're using the Fog of War beautifully. There is a Radiant Observer Wall that's watching also Clockwork pick up that DD rune. And they want to defend middle lane. There's no Blink Dagger on the Earthshaker. But what he was hoping for was just someone to linger around here and only had one choice to back up that direction, then just take that choice away from them. Defense and imprisonment to save some life. Noob. Just deny up that mid tower.
Dire's middle tower has
control
been
warlord. It actually helped out by turning on his ultimate. Bringing assassinations fly. Clockwork. That's a long shot. Sing Sing gets the amplification back over on the clockwork. With the fissure arriving with the rockets. Yeah, you got no hook shot in for this. What you do have is Soshka. Noob. Era missing on the range whirling axe. They found another opening. That's the OT. That's the biggest one of all. He has to self-imprison himself. There's no other choice. I may as well just throw the ulti. The primal split comes off already. And OD, no four staff, no BKB. He can't get himself away. The troll can't help out either. It is a one for one trade off, but they're about to make it two of that ice blast. It's going to come from the clockwork, but nothing more. And the Brulings are going to wear off. They do find another opening, which is the troll. But I don't know if they... Okay, yeah, it's a 4-on-1. It's an opening. The crush comes in, the amplification as well, but they got hit by the rain, by the melee whirling axes. They had a lot of mischances, and Mind Nuts on the run. The clockwork rocket in 5 seconds time. The fissure, off target. So where's clockwork? Have a guess. It's coming in. It's coming in. It's coming. But it doesn't hit my nuts. 132 life points. Yeah, he would have died. He would have died also with a reduction. He would have died.
Do it with flair.
Sorry, 13-11. This game proving to be a lot more of a back and forth kind of thing. As my clockwork couldn't hit his mark. But it seems this mark shall be connected on. Is this level 1? It's level 1. So do your math right there. I think he's okay. Yeah, he's okay. Connects, but no kill. He needed more levels. He did a lot more levels.
Illusion.
Trying to actually see maybe 10 minutes forward in this game. Like, the sniper's finding damage. Let's just look at BU for a moment. So the sniper's building into a Yasha. Potentially SMY, more than likely Manta. Well, the Manta's not really going to help him during the team fights beyond the stats. Sing Sing needs the BKB. There's no other choice here. In fact, I kind of also think that the sniper needs to find his own BKB. It's back to that point of the clockwork with when he turns the blade mail on. There's nothing the sniper can do against him. He's just going to get hit by the battery assault. So because of that, he needs to have his BKB. But, yeah. It's going to take him a long time to get to that point. Especially when Sing Sing is taking a lot of the farm in the jungle. Mind you, observed farm as well. So they know what he's doing. And my nuts. At least he's running a hand of Midas, so these levels, which I was talking about before, he's going to find them. And eventually he'll find his Aghanim Scepter the longer this game goes on. But NIP, they don't need to keep this game going on too long. Are you still running around with an OD troll as well as a clockwork who's on his way towards an Aghanim Scepter? So the clockwork is pretty tanky when he jumps him. It'll take a large commitment from BU to kill him off. Either that or they're all just there at the perfect time with Chilling Touch. But NIP, it's jump in, it's burst damage, it's control. They can fight once this BKB's up for the troll warlord, because BU, they don't really have any major control. The troll, the Slaughter can't stand on the front lines in order to get these, like, bash procs, and he's not going to attack fast enough to say the bash is going to work. It's not as though he's got someone like a troll warlord giving him battle trance. Like, that would make a big difference. And once the OD's got his own BKB, the Brewmaster will be a nothing. Because you got orb damage coming from the OD, and he'll be like just bursting everyone down. The VS and the Ancient Apparition are food. In fact, if this game goes late, is under attack. Like the VS is saving someone and then dead. Where the Ancient Apparition, he's one of these guys where he can be nowhere near the fight. He can leave defensive vortexes so the team can fall back. He can give Chilling Touch every single time. And he can throw his ulti, which he needs to be back Radiant's for anyway, so the radius is bigger. I almost don't want him to be anywhere near the fight. Just throw the ulti at the right time.
Do it with flair.
Radiant's bottom tower is under
attack. NIP are ready to fight this. They're using the clockwork as bait. He's got an ogre club on him as well now. Is there any vision for this? The range whirling axes? That was the first thing that came over towards Sing Sing. Fissure turns on the ulti. Nice swap out, going to go into the split, but the OD comes in, and they're focusing down the Fire Brewling. He's already on the sidelines. Go through the Storm one. The Assassination Bane, where's your Nightmare Brain Tap? Something! Used an ability. He couldn't. The Earth Broom is the last one left alive. The Clockwork misses the hook shot. So TP successfully out for Sing Sing. And Kalmi just trying to hold Ear in position. And in fact, with the Sniper, they're turning back into this one. The Ice Blast is perfect. The OD returns it, however. But NIP, they're committed way too far into this fight. Sing Sing might have still died, but... And... I don't know, like, Vayne died for no real good. The Brewmaster split came and it was kind of a non-factor. And NIP, they... Welcome everybody here to the D2CL. I'm Tubby One, your host for the English live streamer, and I have the power because I have taken over the hosting. There has been some server problems, hence we took so long to actually start up the game, and we had problems initially with BU, then we had problems with our hosts. Both of the admins who were here were unable to actually make any changes inside the lobby. Everything was lagging too much for them. So do not fear, I have an admin ticket. We're launched! We're in! The draft is underway! And the most powerful hero inside the meta is now in the hands of the team who is one game up. But he will be denied the combination. The combination which... Oh, was it...
You
know what? As you get older, your memory starts to fade. We had the combination of Troll and Sniper together yesterday. And the combination was in the hands of... no one. Not from the game of NIP. They had Troll as well as Templar Assassin. Was the combination which, sorry, Team Empire ended up using. There was only one Troll game that came out from NIP yesterday. In the hands of Era, and they used him in a combination with Enigma, Lina, as well as Vengeful Spirit. Their last pickup in that one was also the Clockwork. And as we can see right now, they're not going to get the Vengeful Spirit, but they do have the Clockwork to go with a combination if their heart doth desire to have those things. So, yeah, Clockwork, Troll Warlord. The thing you always have to do, and to kind of flag the fact too when you see a Storm Spirit ban out by MyNuts, because he just knew instantly, Sniper, I'm wanting to pick him. I've got first pick. I'm going to pick the Sniper if they let me have him. So I'm going to take out the jump-based heroes. Batrider and Storm Spirit, two of the greatest ones. Normally you have Batrider as well as Clockwork. I mean, sorry, the Storm Spirit as well as the Clockwork as the two heroes that the greatest at catching out Sniper, because he can't do anything about them coming in on him. It's just not possible. And then the Clockwork obviously keeps him in close with the cogs, and the Storm Spirit is just able to keep on dodging, avoids the shrapnels, and just keeps bouncing around. The Sniper can't get really a lock on him. So... that's the reason why those two heroes were banned out at the very, very start. Looks like MyNuts has also done his homework, taking out that Lina. So he won't give the combination to run. It was a solo mid Lina, which is a little bit of a surprise when they ran the VS and the Lina in the round before as two supports. So the roaming supports, they ran that way. But the Lina was banned out anyway. Disruptor taken out. So more of that wonderful chase mechanism. I'm also thinking that might be because we're looking at a high maneuverable hero. Someone like that. The man who sprints himself to victory. The Slaughter pickup. Interesting choice to have up against someone like a Troll Warlord. The Amplify is going to be crazy. If you actually start thinking about the combinations you get with Amplify, Wave of Terror, and you throw out Shrapnel as well, you're going to get pummeled. And of course, Sniper, with Assassination too, I doubt anyone. Like, you never lose vision of them. You know where you're fighting. You're up against two melee, one semi.
5 seconds remaining.
He's all-rounder. Like, he's not hard, he's not soft. He's just a semi. This Troll Warlord.
Reserve
both
time.
Range and melee. And with the Slaughter selection, this almost feels like a nice early Roshan as well. But they're over on the Radiant side, so it's not just a simple slip yourself in and take out Roshan. It didn't stop Ninjas in Pajamas during the last map. They just ran themselves in. The five-man smoke moved inside. If it wasn't for the Vengeful Spirit with the Wave of Terror, they never would have... well, they would have known. They just wouldn't have been sure what was going on. Okay, so Ninjas in Pajamas... Fourth pick up to go. They have a lot of melee. They need some range. And they know they need some survivability here. I'm really liking BU's lineup. I'm still question marking what's going to happen with the Slaughter. If I was Ninjas in Pajamas right now, I'd make sure that Lion cannot be selected. Because I'm really worried what's going to happen to these NIP players. Actually, is it Lion would be the best one? You kind of want a 4-star hero as well. But the VS has got the swap, so technically she can just save anyone who gets caught inside the cogs if they're worth saving. Really?
Radiant team pick.
Okay. Okay. I'm trying to fully understand this because the Bane really isn't the jump hero I was looking for. You can't... Like, Clockwork's kind of that, but... Understanding the synergy for this. Like, what's your setup? Like, if you had something like a Mirana, then I can kind of understand it. Maybe they're looking at something more like a Latrak, where they can add a lot of early pressure, then there's a lot of spill damage coming out to the Slaughter if he comes for them.
Reserve time.
But the Latrak would just get melted by the Sniper, so that can't really be an option. Then what are they going to do? Put a Troll Warlord up against a Sniper in the mid? You could potentially run a dual lane in mid, but... Okay, you get an Ancient Apparition as well. AA and VS. Quite a powerful combination. Not because you're always thinking like the stun combinations, like you have like the old Rubik's and AA together, where like you know you're going to get your cold feet off, and at level 3 you got your nice burst damage coming out from Rubik, and they've both got some good physical DPS. But with VS adding in the Wave of Terror with the Chilling Touch, just that very early damage you get from VS and AA, like you can't take any fight you want to. And with the Sniper in the mid, you combine all this stuff together, and you've got great battles. And this will buy time for Slaughter to what should be the most obvious pickup in this game. Pick up something like a Vanguard as well as his Blink Dagger. So he's got enough life points to jump in. He'll have that block. And he'll have the survivability as the primary thing. To be in the face of Ninjas in Pajamas and just try and destroy them. Because if he's the one doing that and NIP focus on him, then the Sniper just goes to work
Radiant
sitting at the back lines.
Back.
And that's where I'm still not quite sure about this. Like, how are you meant to get the jump when I'm fairly certain the Clockwork is not going to find a line of fire to get that hookshot into the Sniper, and he's the only one right now. The Puck was the final ban out by NIP, so they have to be worried that it's going to hit massively teamfight controlled. Yeah.
5 seconds remaining.
And Burden United, they could kind of pick anything they want to on this off. You know what I'd actually really
Reserve
like to see?
Time.
I don't know if that'd be perfect. But Timbersaw's in my mind right now for Burden United. Because I think it's just going to... It's nice enough you don't really care about hitting directly. He can shred apart that Troll Warlord. And the Slaughter will take care of kind of everybody else. That's another one of those big tanky guys you can put up in the front line. So you put the Timbersaw on the off lane. Earthshaker and Bane shouldn't be able to harass him out of the lane. And if they do get a little bit more powerful, you just send the VS and the Ancient Apparition up there. And let the Slaughter do his own thing up against the Clockwork. With a simple Stout Shield... an early harassment from the VS Ancient Apparition. Like, they can roam after maybe 1-2 minutes
Dire
into the game,
pick.
If not before that. Like, this 30 seconds worth of damage into the Clockwork. Maybe it'd have to be 1 minute to 2 minutes, because Clockwork will still go for the lane block. But you can get that damage from the VS and AA out. So Clockwork burns through its consumables. So we can't go head-to-head with the Slaughter. And that's where I'm kind of feeling like NIP's lanes are just way too weak. Unless they switch this up and they run something like a Bane, Mirana, Earthshaker offlane, that might work. Then you put the Clockwork up on top. They'll still be very dependent on the last player from Burden United, but Ninjas in Pajamas are the ones that have to make the pick, so BU will see all of the lineup of NIP when they pick up their last hero.
10 seconds remaining.
So NIP, what's the combo with the Bane? Give me some logic here. Is it the same as what I'm thinking? No, it's not. It's just a Bane for control.
Radiant
the Nightmare to stop
pick.
The Slaughter from... You can see, not on cooldown. And he'll probably just grab Hellbear. He'll prefer to have the Troll. It's easier to stack with the Troll. But these Ancients are going to be a priority thing for him. With the Helm of the Dominator as well, he can just go in towards Roshan. So Alpha Wolf or something that can help him do. Or, yeah, just stack the Ancients. That's all he's searching for. Be careful about keeping that bottle on the ground. I think Earthshaker reminded him that bottle was just sitting behind the tower. Top lane, Nightmare. And this will set up now for range into melee walling axis. Still needs to bash. Actually, no, they don't. With the brain sap and the range damage, it's more than enough. The ancient apparition's also gonna die inside the radiant jungle. Looks like a simple walk up and kill him. Was it a haste rune? We had an Earthshaker with a haste rune. Nope, so it wasn't a clockwork. He just must have got him in the fog of war. We are still during our nighttime phase. So vision is pretty sparse. That's how come with me got so close on the OD before in the mid lane. He's been such a nuisance as well. They realize this sniper's not winning the lane as hard as they want to, which means OD's getting momentum. They'll struggle to kill him at the moment. Which is the reason why now they commit three heroes, the two supports and the sniper. He's got DD, the shrapnel will give him the vision, but we can't get in range. The Fissure block will come in, a little bit of orb damage. Actually, he doesn't even have the arcane orb leveled up, but it doesn't matter. Come with me, has to deny himself to the ancients. Use the fog of war, not gonna happen. Salves up, the clockwork, rocket, easy cucka.
Death in a can.
So 8 minutes in, NIP. Rolling with the punches and everything BU keeps throwing at him. Not really working, so they're gonna try and throw something different, the curveball. Take the sniper and the ancient apparition up towards the top, and they're looking for the troll warlord. This one should be a little bit easier. There's no drunken haste, so they try and use the shrapnel instead. But he's got the mischance, assassination, they got the kill. The cold feet's also gonna trigger, and that's a big one. He's worth a lot of experience, but on bottom lane, I think Sing Sing is practically dead. Hook shot, off cooldown. There's your first fissure into the battery assault. They just try and hold him here. OD's still got imprisonment, so they can set up for this one. Yeah, they will do so. Cogs are back off cooldown, and they'll hold him. And there's nowhere for Sing Sing to go. Trapped in electrical death. We go 3-7 now on the board. Trade-off for trade-off. The solos for the solos. And the mid-solos, the safe lane solos for the safe lane solo. The mid-solos are the ones being involved. Earthshaker. With the assassination, Earthshaker should be really careful. He's already dropping very low. And, well, he could with a stun. Come with me. He doesn't have a magic missile. Great TP out. Troll Warlord kill off the Brewmaster in the meantime on the top lane. Looks like a bit of an assist coming in with the hook shot. But after picking that kill up, he's going to go jungle. He's got the helm of the Dominator, so he just wants to walk through his jungle and just keep farming that one up and give the top lane to the Clockwork. So this allows Clockwork to farm up to getting his Blade Mail. Which basically means Sniper is going to start killing himself unless he builds a BKB. Same for the VS, same for the Slaughter. The Slaughter doesn't want to do that. The arm choice I was saying before was going to be something like a Vanguard. Up against an OD, I don't know if Slaughter's really going to be feeling as confident with that. Just start off with a Blink Dagger. Jump in, get the kill, move on. That should be the goal. We're going to battle for top. Fissure. The initial stun wouldn't have done enough, and the Observer Ward sitting on the dire side of the river is what allowed the Sniper to see that coming. That just means they have to give up the rune. But it's a double damage rune coming into Bane. That's not as bad. Is that Treads for... Yeah, it's Treads for Era, in fact. Kind of surprising, but he went to the jungle. Wait, hang on. So he's building a Maelstrom? Middle lane, goodbye Sniper. Nightmare. I love how Bane also gets the Arcane proc. The Essence Aura. Love it. Clockwork side in the meantime up on top lane. Brewmaster split. Nope. Just done Wave of Terror and Clap doing the work. Impressive for a Clockwork to die when he's got Tranquils as well as the Blade Mail. He had to be low before that started.
Yes.
I think OD's dead. I'm certain OD is dead. I saw the AA ulti coming in, realized, wait, Sing Sing's moved towards the middle lane. He hit the Blink Dagger timing. So he went directly for the blink, and that's what it's all about. Just jump in, don't let NIP react. Dire's middle tower, and then you got to keep doing this. You can't just get one pick and be happy with that. You have to find more, and that's what looking towards bottom lane. Using the Vortex with the Shrapnel combination. They're not going to kill off Earthshaker, but with that damage, it's going to be enough to force him back. And Era, it's the same time he went in for Roshan. Come with me, scouted him out. He found an Alpha Wolf, thought he had enough damage, and he did have enough Dire's damage to kill off Roshan. But with the pressure starting to mount, yeah, it looks like Slaughter again finding another kill. This time they do use the Brewmaster split. Well, I was too busy watching Roshan. But Sing Sing pushing everyone back. Dire's so with Clockwork dead, Again, the blade mail gets even more delayed. Fortified. He's got the most expensive part of it left to purchase. We're gonna go on mid. There's your stun. Crush. Ice blast. Holy crap. They're getting schooled. Like, BU are getting so schooled right now. There's at least one opening here for Era. Come with me. He does have a magic missile stun. The chilling touch. Potentially they could turn him with a shrapnel. Era, they need more of a slowdown. OD just locks it. Does the imprisonment. Takes out my nuts. And forces him back. Now, for everything that's still going on, for all these great, like, roaming ganks are coming out from Sing Sing, he's finding openings, we're getting Mask of Madness over on Sniper. The Brewmaster's not looking great, but he's getting closer and closer to the Blink Dagger. He's at least able to do something during the fights when he's got some teammates to help him out. Like, he's about to do on the top lane. Sing Sing just TP'd up here. So they're battling for the last hit. Soshka, wow, that Echo Slam. Middle is heavy and Sing Sing. He's wanting to wait for the secondary TP in, but he got the timing wrong. So OD imprisons over on Sing Sing, denies up the tower and the Earthshaker. Waited out. Now he can go for the Fitch, but the assassination. He should have just thrown it. The Nightmare coming out from Bane is already too late now. In fact, he blocks the hook shot. This allows the Brewmaster to get away. The Ice Blast is on the way here. Sing Sing, one more orb. The rockets fly. Something. They can't reach him. He denies. Nope. He blinks and runs. On 36 life points. What level is that rocket?
Radiant's
level 2.
Bottom tower is under attack.
They can see him. But getting that prediction rocket is going to be so hard. But it's worth a go. They scattered it out. Sing Sing's fine. Roshan's not, though, with Era. The Alpha Wolf is going to try and turn, but Ancient Apparition throws out the Ice Blast. And my nuts get chilly on top of the Troll Warlord. Even finding a DD rune. The Earthshaker. Well, you might feel confident enough to hold the Ancient Apparition in position for maybe 2-3 seconds, but beyond that, you're not going to find any other confidence. He'll just drop very quickly. And now it's going to be BU's turn. I said they're a very quick Roshan team. With 3 points up in the Wave of Terror, they had to trigger. Oh, Clark! Whoa, he's in! Soshka has a split inside the pit. The Fissure also splits him up a little bit more. The Clockwork's going to die very quickly, but Roshan clamping him. They had to smoke. It protects them from Roshan beating into him. Because there's no other heroes. They're not revealing themselves, so Roshan's not going to try and clap him again. Not anytime soon while the Brueling sends the Bane into the air. Where's your extra help? The Sniper as well as Kalmi are locked in the river. Era comes in, one attack and Kalmi will die. Nice Fidget controls up the Sniper and now BU. They got a great start by killing off that Clockwork. He did jump in crazily with the Cog Push. But NIP waited out perfectly. They realized the Brewmaster split's gone. There's no way that they chase this. This happened to them last night up against Team Empire. It was a different case in that game because they were looking. Yeah, stop being a dick, Sing. I see that. It was different in that case because NIP thought they could take a melee Rax, and they really could, and they couldn't back up in time, and they did a semi-turn, and it wasn't quite right. In this case, they didn't turn, yet they knew they'd lost the fight. When that Ice Blast connected, they were dead. Because the sniper just ran in, dished out all the damage he wanted to, and killed them all. Obviously, there was a lot of other help going into that, but I just was really surprised how ineffective NIP was in that fight. Really, really, really surprised. So Roshan's up in 52 seconds. NIP have to make sure that BU did not get this, or else that next team fight is just dead to them. OG's going to get connected on by the Ice Blast, but it's merely chip damage right now. It is level 11. But it doesn't have the... Actually, it will really soon. A 5-1-3 on the Ancient Apparition. That last fight, I didn't realize just how far it injected money into him. He's been running the mines, which has already been fantastic, but an Aghanim Scepter and 250 gold. What's the Sniper got? What's over on the Courier? Now, it looks like it's an Earn Start for Come With Me. Or an Earn Finish for Come With Me. Actually, no, it's not. He doesn't know the recipe. That's a problem. The one thing they do have is Slade on his way to a BKB. The full Vlad's over on the Brewmaster, and he's also starting up on his BKB. Well, the Earthshaker got his Blink Dagger. So with ES with this, BU's next team fight should not be as good. Like, it was still kind of crazy because NIP blew everything. Like, the hook shot was well off target. The Echo Slam was a non-factor. The OD ulti, and Bane was dead at the start. Like, no nightmare defense. The assassination, sure, it's going to do a lot of damage to you, but at least try and brain zap something and attempt to survive. It's a level 2 assassination. A level 4 brain zap should be our deal with that. With the life points he had, of course. Is under attack. So pushed out to the T1 tower on bot. Clockwork. Do they have any vision of this? Even if they had wards, it doesn't protect them from the smoke. Nice aggressive ward down from BU. So they see everything. The rocket flies. Scouts out both Soshka as well as my nuts. But Singh and Kawami are waiting for this. The Chilling Touch bonus on Singh, and he gets a double clap. Perfect as well. Follow up into the Brewmaster split. Bane again, dead before the fight even begins. The clockwork will drop as well. Get the hell out of there. The assassination will connect on the Earthshaker. It scattered the fact the OD was TPing. Singh Singh, blink clap on. He misfingered his keyboard right then. The click was on the wrong button, I think. Because that crush could have come out instantly. It was off cooldown when he blinked himself in. And that would have been a threefer. Either way, I said before, NIP can't allow BU to take this Roshan. Because by doing so, they now win the next fight. It's almost a guarantee that they win the next fight. The Aegis Immortal into Sing Sing here. He's going to be even more aggressive on the map. The Sniper doesn't really need much to keep going, but he's up to 2,000 gold. I am still assuming BKB. I highly doubt the Desolator. Fissure. Are they going for this? No. No. The Troll Warlord doesn't have a way just to get himself in. He didn't buy a Blink Dagger. Instead, he bought the BKB and still just walking around with a casual Yasha in the helm of the Dominator. No Troll has been converting that into the full Satanic effect. It's like the very last item that you change. As a Troll, it's just perfect for grabbing the creep. It's nice damage, it's good armor, and it's great lifesteal. Everything a good Troll needs. And that's the last thing he needs, that Blink Dagger. I mean, the next thing he needs, not the last thing he needs. We get Ancient Apparition in a great spot. With an Aghanim Scepter, he could literally AFK here and just throw out Ice Blast after Ice Blast after Ice Blast. I think that he wants to join the rest of his team. Do we have smoke on them? Not right now. But you just got double BKBs. So you got two 10-second BKBs for BU during the next engagement, and an Aegis the Immortal over on the Slaughter. Now, they're going to reveal the fact, like, look at 6, he moved up so quickly to try and find a hero, but NIP backed out so early. They backed out before BU even arrived for their T1 tower. OD. He really has no choice for this. Because the amount of damage the Ice Blast does to him this early on, and there's no mech. Like, it's not like the old days of the OD where you could use Buckler and that would trigger your Essence Aura. Oh, nice. Clockwork. That Invis Rune's going to do him some work. Bane, so much trouble. He at least got his Brain Zap off this time. The Urshaker could have bought some time with another Fissure, but he couldn't see the right line where he could get the Bane out of there. But even if it was a Fissure so he can Brain Zap Nightmare 1, that could have helped. And he had a Blink Dagger to get himself into the perfect spot too. Oh, NIP, they're not displaying that wonderful team fight I saw last night up against Team Empire. They may have been underestimating BU. Like, Bird and United have played a fantastic game today. They're moving aggressively. Their drafts have been wonderfully done by my nuts. That's an aggressive TP out. And a very quick blink away. That cost Sing Sing nothing. Like, what, 150 mana? He's still got Aegis the Immortal. He doesn't care at the moment. I still got another 2 minutes left on that Aegis. So Sing's going to go back and heal up. And then sprint down to the bottom lane. And that should be where they push. In 2 minutes, that bottom wave should be able to reach the tier 2 tower. they're actually going to fight into this. The Aegis is still up. I don't know why NIP are here. The Echo Slam's going to drop. The Brewmaster swapped out by Come With Me. Saved at the last moment. He's going to blink, clap. And in fact, he just blink splits. Era's down for the count. You're going to go for your Fiend script. But as I said before, the Bane pick doesn't make any sense because you're just going to get disabled straight away. There's too many disables on the field. Blink down. The Cogs push it back. He TP'd out. He's not there. So Sing Sing can just chase somebody else. But NIP, this game is completely out of control. Completely. It was like the same position we were at before when Sing Sing had his PL in game number one. You just look at it, and you don't understand where they can find the team fight. And you also don't understand why NIP was trying to fight that. Like, they've already lost their outer towers apart from that tier 2 on bottom. Are they looking to try and engage on a BU? Because they did over on Brewmaster, but they couldn't even save him. I mean, they couldn't even kill him. Come On Me just came in, swapped him out, and you're good to go. And you can expect BU to just be 5-manning at the moment, because you still have the Aegis of the Immortal. But this Aegis is going to time out in, what, 30 seconds? So NIP fought into an Aegis. They fought on the wrong side of the map. And they couldn't get their initial kill, which was the Brewmaster. VS doesn't have a range for that swap. If Kalmi had something like a 4-star for a Blink Dagger, then maybe he'd make it. In fact, he would have made it if he had a Blink Dagger. And even look at OD. I'm surprised he didn't get something like a 4-star. Because I would have preferred to see the stats out from a 4-star. I think it would still do the same job as what he's looking for out of the Blink Dagger. But it really does feel like NIP doesn't have confidence to get the initial jump. Like, you got a Clockwork with an Aghanim Scepter as well. Like, you should have all